Welcome to this new inside code video where we'll see the find all anagrams in a string problem. So what does the problem say? It says, given a string s and a not empty string p, create a function that returns an array that contains all the start indices of p's anagrams in s. Know that both strings are made of lowercase English letters. First of all, what are anagrams? Two strings are considered as anagrams if they are rearrangements of the same characters. For example, stress and desert are anagrams. And to check if two strings are anagrams, we just have to check that they have the same number of occurrences of each letter. In our last example, both stress and deserts have 1D, 2E, 1R, 3S, and 1T. Now that we know what are anagrams, we can start solving our problem. Here is an input-output example. You can see that we can find anagrams of P at indexes 0, 5, and 6. And in order to find them, we will use the sliding window technique. An important detail to know is that anagrams must have the same length, so our window will always have the same size. We will use the sliding window technique because we want to check if the substring whose size is length of p that starts at index 0 is an anagram of p, then the one that starts at index 1, and so on. And to check if two strings are anagrams, we have to traverse them to count occurrences of each letter, then compare maps. So if we keep repeating this operation at each index of s, we'd end up with a time complexity of O of n times m, where n is the length of s and m is the length of p. Because at each index, we have to retraverse the substring from index I to index I plus length of p. But fortunately, we can avoid this. The idea to optimize the solution is that instead of always recounting occurrences of each letter, we can just update our actual map by decrementing one in occurrences of the character that went out of the window and incrementing one in occurrences of the character that entered the window. And because strings are made of lowercase English letters, we can just use an array of 26 elements where each element represents the number of occurrences of one letter. And because maps will always contain 26 elements no matter the size of S and P, comparing the map of S and the map of P runs on O of 1 time complexity. This is why our final complexity will be O of n. Let's see how all this process works with our last example. First step, we create our arrays of 26 elements. They all start at 0 because we didn't start counting yet. Second step, we fill P map by occurrences in P and S map by occurrences in the first window. First index, we increment occurrences of A in PMAP and occurrences of C in SMAP. Second index, we increment B in PMAP and B in SMAP. And third index, we increment C in PMAP and A in SMAP. Now you can see that SMAP and PMAP are equal, so we already have an anagram at index 0. We put 0 into our output. Last step, we traverse the remaining indexes while updating SMAP and comparing. Index 3, the character that went out of the window is C, and the one that entered the window is E, so we decrement C and increment E in SMAP. SMAP and PMAP are not equal, so we do nothing. Next index, we decrement B and increment B, still not equal. Next index, we decrement A and increment C, not equal. Next index, we decrement E and increment B, still not equal. Next index, we decrement B and increment A, and here they are equal, so we push I minus length of P plus 1, which is 5 in our case. Next index, we decrement C and increment C, also equal, so we push I minus length of P plus 1, which is 6 in our case. Next index, we decrement B and increment D, here they are not equal. And we finish traversing S, and we got that indexes of anagrams of P and S are 0, 5, and 6. Before moving to the code, you need to understand something about SMAP and PMAP. In both of them, occurrences of A are at index 0, B at index 1, and so on. So we have to find a way to map a letter to its index in SMAP and PMAP. In order to do so, we can calculate the ASCII code of the letter minus the ASCII code of lowercase a. For example, the ASCII code of lowercase d is 100, and the ASCII code of lowercase a is 97, so the difference is 3. This is why the index of occurrences of the letter d is 3. And in code, we write ord of letter minus ord of lowercase a. Ord is the Python function that returns the char code of the pass parameter. Now we can move to the code of our solution, but before, please take some seconds to like the video and to subscribe to the channel. For the code of this solution, we first put the only exit condition that says that if p is longer than s, we cannot find an anagram of p in s, so we return an empty array. Then we create our output array, we create SMAP and PMAP, which are two arrays of 26 elements, and we fill them. In order to fill them, we use the for loop where I goes from 0 to length of p, and at each index, we increment in SMAP the element at index ord of s of I minus ord of lowercase a as explained before, and in pmap, the element at index ord of p of I minus ord of lowercase a. Now that we have the set of SMAP and PMAP for the first window, we compare them, and if they are equal, it means that the first window is an anagram of P, we append 0 to output. Now we can start traversing the remaining indexes. We start from index length of P and not from 0 because we already traversed from 0 to length of P in the first for loop. At each iteration, we decrement the occurrences of the letter that went out of the window, the one at index I minus length of p, and we increment occurrences of the one that entered the window, the one at index I, and we compare SMAP and PMAP to see if we found an anagram. And if they are equal, it means that we found an anagram that starts at index I minus length of p plus 1, so we append I minus length of p plus 1 to output. After the loop, we just return output. For the time complexity, we are traversing indexes of s, and at each index, we are performing O of 1 work as explained before, so the time complexity is O of n, where n is the length of s. And for the space complexity, even if SMAP and PMAP have a constant amount of elements, but don't forget that we are using extra space for the output array, so the space complexity is O of n. I hope that you understood how we use the sliding window technique to solve this problem and how we optimize the solution. Comment below what you thought about the video and see you in the next one.